Hey, welcome back everybody to another episode of Creativerse. You guys see, we got a mess. Not really, the chests and stuff are still the same as it was before, but it ended right behind here. And I have too much stuff. And before I start building any big projects and so on, I really would like to clean up. When you look through, you know, some of these chests here, I almost said quests, that's weird. Yeah, I got all this sandstone here, more sandstone there. Over here I got multiple chests of stone. Where's the other one? And there's just so many blocks. I mean, it's nuts, okay? How many different things. And a lot of stuff is out here that I've been starting to collect. I'll show you real quick. Right out here on the other side of the tunnel. I started to go around and start collecting a bunch of leaves and the flowers of those trees. And there's lots more I need to do. But I really don't want to have them out here, even though I'm going to have my project out here where we're going to build our flower farm. I don't want to have it out here. So this is what kind of triggered. I'm like, all right, I don't have any more room. And I would like to make this not very straightforward. I don't know how to explain it. I don't want to have, you know, just rows of chests. I kind of want to have categories, you know, like one section full of trees and leaves with a few machines to process those, and then split up other things. For example, up until recently, I didn't know that you can place flowers again. I did not know that. I actually mentioned that as a suggestion on the forums, and then people are like, you know, this works already. And I was surprised. For example, you know, I always thought you can just now use these to make dyes or whatever, but you can actually place them again. So that's really cool. And the same, for example, with, let me think here. Where did I just get this from? Didn't I just get this out of this chest? Oh, there we go. I put the chest in there by mistake. And I also found out that you can do it, for example, with this right here, with the fossil. I also didn't know that, you know, it doesn't look like a block. So I didn't know you can place those again. And I want to use somehow these blocks as markers, what is in the chests, and or maybe in a section kind of thing, because some things you cannot, you know, place again. For example, these flowers right there, you can place them like this, but it's not a block, so it's going to be a little difficult to do, but I'll figure something out. So I just wanted to show you guys the room before I get started with the organizing. And I went to the edge of the actual mountain here. So always the same way, and I kept it with the sandstone up here and the ruddy canyon stone right there. And I don't know yet if this is going to be all see-through glass, or I don't know. Excuse me, got the hiccups. I don't know what I'm going to do here yet. But I want to set up the chests and so on first, start getting a better idea, and then I'll show you guys what my plan is before, you know, I just finish everything, because that's going to be kind of boring. So I'll BRB. Hey guys, we're gonna have a little side project here real quick. Sheridan needs a bunch of corrupted stone. And, well, it's a pain in the butt to get it down in the corrupted layers. And I read that it's possible to make a corrupted stone farm, and we kind of want to play with this. And I thought I'd record it, so if you guys have the same idea or you built something like that, maybe you can tell us. Do you get any more siltstone? Ran out.
You want me to go get some?
Let's see here. I'll just use the stalactite for right now. We can change this in a minute.
All right.
So I figured that... Let me just get... Dang it. Get up here close, D3. So...
I've got about a stack if you want me to bring
it. I got tons at home. Oh, you're coming over here? Then you can bring it, yeah. So what I figured is, you know, we put the ice up there, so it melts.
Put it now?
And then it runs down. Yeah, try that out. And we'll make it look good later, that's no problem. You're like stuck in a jumping position on my screen.
Yeah, you look like it too.
Which portal?
Your little guy, he is in a jumping position.
Probably, it's melted, okay. See, now this is running down, and then I figured that once you corrupt this, and then you can place the blocks. Why are we... Wait, what is this? Why can't I... Oh, I can't. You see, and then you can place the blocks down there. Six of them, and they should turn corrupted, and then you can pick them up again.
The stone you can place down there?
Yeah. So you can never mess up the source. I'm, like I said, this is just guessing.
A turtle bomb?
Hold on a second. If Mike just brought... Is this really a whole chest full of stone? Oh, yeah.
No, the other one.
You got a little plans here. I forgot. Let's just change this real quick, just so it looks a little better. We don't need this. And bam,
Mike,
bam,
that
bam.
Whenever you get ready, that portal to that what's it called? That showroom.
Yeah.
Is there's a new portal in the hub. Oh, and there's a bunch of recipes too. I don't know if you've been in there lately, but you might want to check them out too.
What block do I look for?
It's the lily pad.
Yeah. Okay, go ahead and throw that corruption bomb now.
Your guy looks weird as hell. Oh, now he looks better. Yeah, throw it in there.
Yep.
Why'd you back up? Won't you stand right there?
No thanks.
It doesn't do anything, man.
All right, now it's corrupted, so...
That looks cool. Oop.
And I thought that the corrupted water, maybe you have to place it. Yeah, I thought that this corrupted stone...
I bet you it's like corrupted. Everything else, man. I bet you it's going to take a while before it does anything. And these black blocks, can they be stone also?
The silt?
Yeah.
No, I don't think so.
It has to be the ones on the bottom?
Well, I don't know yet. It supposedly is turning these.
Oh.
I just wanted to be a new, like an update or something.
Right.
Well?
Because those ones in that pool, they changed. I don't know when they changed, but they did change. Because I just put regular stone to begin with.
But that was all source blocks, right?
Yeah. Yeah, they were.
Man, I'm getting... Where is it here?
You gonna die.
Let me hug
That's
this a little
idea.
Bit.
Yeah.
Alright, how about now? Nope. I'm just gonna go down and come back up. Come down here, maybe that helps.
Yeah.
And how about now? Ah.
Oh, wrong portal.
Yes.
Well, maybe that'll help it.
Yeah. I wish these loading screens weren't that long.
I know.
Coal farm.
Sometimes I think it's only so you can read those little things.
Building underwater bases is really
hard.
Yeah,
that's it, Mike.
Lily pad, is this the new one?
Yes, sir, that's it.
Thank you.
Hold your breath, because it's going to startle you.
No, it didn't turn.
Oh, man.
Let me do some investigating here for a minute.
Right.
Well, guys, it seems like this is not possible anymore. I'm not sure what we're doing wrong. We're actually down at the corruption layer and tried it in the corruption. You know, this is an original pool right there, and there's, you see the stone down there, and it does not turn into corrupted stone. So we don't know what we can do to do this. If you guys have any idea if this is still possible, please let me know down in the comments. Otherwise, I'll get back to work on the storage room now. A ton of trial and error went into trying to figure out what to use as the building blocks on the side. I wanted to somewhat keep the canyon colors, but the canyon blocks themselves aren't that pretty. The ones that you can craft yet, at least. And we got this, what is this called here? The yellow mosaic tile wall, which I think looks really cool as the border on the bottom. And then on the top, I wanted to have a nicer block than just the sandstone. So tried out all kinds of yellowish ones. And this yellow concrete looks the best to me. So that's what I went with. I just did the border bottom and top. And then I just started to move the chests around a little bit. This haze, by the way, I'm not sure what that is. It was a couple times now. I don't know if it's morning or what are we looking at here? Yeah, it seems to be morning. So maybe this is a morning haze or something. I don't know. And over here, yeah, everything. When I have had it first, it looked, you know, kind of naked with just this yellow concrete. But then I said, you know what? I'm going to start with the chests and stuff first. And that definitely looks better this way when there's stuff in front of this. So if there's going to be gaps and so on, I'm going to try to figure out what decoration to use here. And I wanted to have kind of a librarian storage kind of look. That's why I'm using the bookshelves as dividers. And the lights up here are, for now, I'm not particularly happy about these right here. But the thing is, anywhere else I put them, you see how everything gets really dark? Like if I put them just up here, for example, that's where I had them initially. And I thought it looked pretty cool. But then the whole front of these is dark. You see that? So then I would have to put another light somewhere in front just to light this up. And then, well, then I might as well just save on lights and just put them like this. And I said I'm just going to leave it for now like this and then figure out maybe I can make it a little hidden or use some other materials and so on. Now, the sorting's my idea behind this itself is I kind of want to have it like by the mining layers. And that almost works out that way. So right here we got these and the floor I want to keep. I want to have these as the quick indicator. I don't know where else to put them. I was thinking of putting them back here. But let me just show you here real quick so you can see what I'm talking about. But you can't see them anymore. You gotta then hover over them to figure out what is this. So I'm just gonna leave them here and I don't know what I'm gonna do with the floor yet. Now where is it? Right there. Let's put this back here. And by the way, if you put lights or something back here, it's useless. You can see the light, but it doesn't really do anything. And I'm kind of hoping, I gotta make a post about that. It would be nice if they would make chests non-opaque, so they let light through. Then we wouldn't have any of this problem with these dark walls behind it, because I think it's ugly. Honestly, I don't like that these walls are dark behind it. And it's been like that for a long time, as long as I can remember playing this game. So it would be nice if they make these, because, you know, other blocks like, I don't have it, like leaf blocks or the tourmaline glass and so on. They all let light through 100%. So all these chests are not taking up the whole spot. So hopefully they will listen to us and let us have light behind them. Anyways, so this is kind of, I got stone, bedrock, and limestone. And I'm, you know, filling them from the bottom up. So I want to have three of each of those because some of them are not yet filled, but, well, if I go any more mining, you know, this is going to fill up. And I don't want to have to mess around anymore. So just these. And then I figured once they fill up, then I might replace them for architect chests or something. And then here we continue with siltstone and stalactite. And then this row right here is a special one here. Right now, I got the magnetite, salt, and mud. And, oops, I forgot one. Oh yeah, the mold right there. I forgot, I didn't want to separate this. And once I have, you know, too much of either of these, then I might split it up into three different chests. But for now, I know if it's none of these from the first three layers, it's two layers. This is anywhere from the obsidian and iron layer. This is more on the iron layer. This is more... Yeah, these first three are more on the iron layer, while this is more on the obsidian layer. They do spawn pretty much everywhere, but anyway, just so you guys know what I'm about up to now. And now I'm going to have a third section here for the lava layer stuff. And then I think I'm going to start putting something here and then figure out where I'm going to put the corrupted stuff. I'm not sure about that yet. But when I got pretty much everything laid out, then I'll show you guys what I have done, and then we'll take it from there. I can tell you guys it's been over 2 weeks since I've been here last. It took me forever to get back to recording here. I had PC issues, my power supply burned out. It took forever, like half a week, to get a new power supply here in my area. And then, well, it took me over a week to get back into the groove of recording and catching up on all my different series. But I am back, and I should be able to make more episodes again on Creativerse. And I'm really happy about it. I miss this place. I love this game. And we also had another update. R17? 18? I don't remember the numbers. The one where resist potions now give you 100% protection from the environmental meters. So that's a nice surprise. But the moving is so weird. I don't remember it being this weird. It's like I'm stuttering over every block. Do you guys see that? I don't know. It just feels so weird to me. And yeah, let's forget about the moving issues. I'm sure that they're going to be fixed, or I just have to get used to them. The storage area is done. I actually finished this just before my power supply burned up. And wow, I like it. It turned out good. Man, I had to play around with these lights so many, many different ways. And then I finally came up with them, just putting them into the ceiling. And the lighting seems okay this way. There's none of these real dark shadows anywhere in front of the chests and stuff now. So I'm happy about that. I had a bunch of these machines here in the middle. You know, I wanted to kind of have the middle area here for processing. But it just looks bad. There was always a few machines that had complete black sides. You know, where there was like no light coming in, so they were 100% black shadow. I didn't like it. So the inside is still empty. I do kind of want to change the floor just a little bit here on the inside. Almost like give it a rug feeling or worn feeling. But I'm not going to spend any time on that now. It is all done. I'm happy about that. We got all the, you know, lava layer stuff here, and there's more. And then here I started with the corruption layer stuff. Also the wood is here. That's the only wood that's not over there in this row. And then we got the sandstone, ruddy canyon stone, the dark canyon stone, which I barely have any, but hey, that's why there's only one chest. And the rest of the canyon stone, and I also put sand in here for now. Because, well, I don't think I'm ever gonna have as much sand. And then here I got peak stone, because I farmed this for a while. I want to make a farm with this peak stone. And here is the different dirts I have. And I had to use this dead grass instead of dirt, because if I put dirt down here, the grass is going to spread. And here's a few different grasses. My touchstone. And then here I have snow stuff. And of course this here is a limestone wall. It looks the closest to snow, so it cannot melt. And then you get the idea, every one of the different trees with the corresponding leaves. You guys seen, I was very busy the last few days just collecting leaves for the project I want to get started now, and that is to make a flower farm. I have an idea for that. I'll talk you through in a minute. Then here is flowers and dyes, hollow logs, and then this here is, you know, grasses and bee things, and then other items that are cluttered, you know. And then over here is all mob drops. This is the higher level stuff, I'm calling it. Here is all the leafy and overworld stuff. And check this out, I got an Ood the Pixie. That is apparently from the last update too. There was some slime blocks added or something like that. Jump blocks, bouncy blocks. And this is like all kinds of bone stuff. And then over here is all building blocks, all different kinds. And I couldn't figure out how to organize those. So these are kind of like, to me, see-through things. Entry glass, wooden products. Here is decoration items. Here I have stairs and roofs. And here is some stone products, I'm going to call them. And here's a lot of the adobe and concrete. And this one right here is, I'm going to call them fancy blocks, a little more expensive. And this one is all wooden decorative blocks. So yeah, that's it. And then I have over here, it's a different corner, you know, like bombs and potions. Here I'm going to have, you know, I have, you know, spare armor and power cells. And here I have lighting and, you know, like a fan. I was playing around with that, beacons and so on. And then here we have crafting materials. I see the glob of goo was changed. different color. I first thought I found something new, but then I read a little bit of coal, processing a ton of obsidian rods. And over here is the main metals, and then up here is the fancy gem stuff. So that's it. Now, I noticed one thing. First of all, the recipe for the advanced extractor, or super extractor, sorry, has doubled, which I think is fine because, oops, I forgot to bring some stone. Because it was before this last update, the super extractor cost half as much as the advanced. So I think it's fair that that costs more now. And I'm okay with that, but that's why I'm preparing so many of the different rods, just so I can make a bunch again. And you guys see in my inventory, I got the 10 different leaf blocks in the game. I think that is all of them. If you know of any other ones I forgot, let me know. But we got, of course, the Ashenwood, the Elderwood, and the Craigwood. Those are the main ones that were in the game from, well, as long as I've been playing it. Then I got 3 different color autumn woods, and they all can get this, I'm gonna call it the white flower. It looks kind of white. Then we got wildwood leaves and weepwood leaves. And then we also have the shorewood leaves and the parchwood leaves. I believe this one, and I believe no, the wildwood gets flowers, the weepwood gets flowers, all the other ones get flowers, the parchwood and the shorewood, I believe. Those two I have not found any flowers. But I'm still gonna make a farm for them in case there's ever gonna be any flowers added, and just to have them all. In case they're just rare and I've never found any, who knows. So, flower farm. I want to build out here, right here in this area. And, well, I was thinking about, you know, design. What kind of design do I want to make? I don't just want to make a farm. And what I figured here is we got 10 different flowers. And, I should say, 10 different leaves. And I was thinking that's too much to make one big flower, okay? I want the leaves to be the petals of the flower, and then the center of that I want to be to grow bees, or the whatever they're called, beeswax, and another one for cactus, because cactus now grows flowers with the latest update. They regrow their flowers, which you can see right there. There was none before, and it actually grew one on top. So that's really cool. So I figured the middle, whatever you call that from a flower, the middle, you know, where the bees go and they get the honey out, or they get the nectar out to make into honey. That's what I want that to be. So I figured, you know, with 10 different leaf blocks, that's too much. So I want to split this up into 2 flowers. So we're gonna have one flower like right here and another flower maybe over here. And for that, I'm going to lay this out now. I kinda wanna get a feel for the layout. I have no idea how I'm gonna make these petals, to tell you the truth, but I kinda wanna get started with somewhat the center, trying to figure out. So I want, you know, this road right here to run by the corner of the edge of the flower. So let's say from right here. Let's give ourselves one gap, so right there. This is the edge of one flower and of one of the petals here. So then, you know, the petal is gonna come, with 5, I'm gonna make a 5 petal flower. So this is gonna be 1, and let's say, like I said, I have no idea how I'm gonna do that. And I think I'm just gonna go ahead and start laying out, trying to figure out what kind of a design might look good. And then I think we'll take it from there. Just, I gotta start laying it out somewhere, otherwise I'll never get a hang of the dimensions or how to make these petals and that kind of thing.
This is funny, guys. Check it out. There's one of these baby crabs. And I don't know what's going on, but he walked into the teleporter right there, which is connected to up there. And he just keeps coming down from the teleporter and then going back into that one and back up there and coming back down. Let's watch it. Oh, this is funny. So this took me, I think, 2 hours. That's it. It's crazy. I even made a Lumite power cell because it makes, you know, picking up the sand and stuff for landscaping so much faster. I mean, look at the speed. Even compared to a diamond. The diamond is a little bit slower, but this one definitely takes the cake. And I had to do a lot of... Here he goes. Let's see him. And bam, he goes back in and he's back up there. You see him? Now he's gonna come back down. So, you guys, they're annoying here when you're trying to build something. Get out of here. Ow. Alright, now all my armor is broken. Luckily, I have backup in that chest. Jesus, can you? Uh-oh. Oh, my goodness. Alright, let's go back and get our stuff. I'm gonna get this backup armor now. Well, backup is just a set that parts are from Sheridan, and because he's spending so much time down at the corruption lair that he's killed so many things. That's what they actually called the mob down there, the thing. He keeps getting all this diamond armor and so on, so he's been sharing it with all of us. And this guy, what's going on with the lag here? What's happening? And this guy has been looking in this sand block for the last 2 hours. Every time I come here, he stands there. All right, is something on me? No. Come here, you punk. I don't know why I'm lagging. I start recording and I'm lagging. And that's not on my end. That's definitely not me. I don't ever have any problems in this game. All right, here everything is, ugh, what a mess. Let's just get all of this back here. All right, guys, so I first started building, you know, willy-nilly. Just trying to get this done without, you know, a plan, pretty much. And it's so hard trying to get 5 petals in a flower in a sandbox game. 4, 8, anything even would have been easier. There he comes again. I don't know why this is cracking me up so much. And of course, I had to do a lot of landscaping here. It's not terraforming, it's landscaping. Because, well, I needed the room. And then this is the other thing, is I don't want any sandstone here. I want it to be all sand. And there's still lots more to do. So let's take a look at it from above so you guys can get a better idea of what it looks like. So that is the flower. I think it turned out pretty good. It doesn't need to be all symmetrical, but it does look like a flower. I hope you guys can see that. 5 petals around the middle. And now my first problem is, and I want you guys' help with that, please. Go down in the comments and let me know how you guys think I should handle it. I want to have a second one. We have 10 different leaves. Now this covers 5 right now. So I was thinking of possibly simply making a second one like this on top of it. Because the whole idea was to have it out here near the base, because you can see we're standing in, all this is loaded. Over there you see some beeswax. I think those yellow things are beeswax on those parchwood. I think they can grow there. So this stays loaded. I did not want to build this somewhere far away because, oh my lord, I didn't even see. He finished the whole mountain with the corrupted stone. Wow, that must have been a lot of work. Crazy. Anyways, it's getting sidetracked. I have to check this out later. So I think the best thing is to put another one on top. And if not, then I think the second one, should I put it here? Or possibly back there? I don't want to go back there because I'm afraid that's too far away. I think overall it would be best to just add a second layer or something on top of it. But let me know what you guys think. I'm going to go with the majority, either second layer or make a second flower to the side. But now, you know, between this and next episode, what I am going to do is trying to figure, I'm going to need to, you know, shave this back a little bit over here and make it, you know, more natural looking. I don't want this to be touching right there. Here he goes again. This guy is on a mission. And then this over here, shave it back a little bit. Now, my thinking is, let's go back real quick. The outside, I don't know if I want to make the border that you guys just saw with the
with the stone, if I want to make this something, for example, where is it? I think it is in here. This is the yellow concrete. That's what I was thinking right there. That's this what I'm using here. And let's just go with the Craigwood for right now. Now, my other thinking is that I think I have five somewhat green looking. This Wildwood, Craigwood, Shorewood, Weepwood, and Elderwood. These are going to be one flower. And then the second flower, which would be the one I would put on top, would be all the more colorful one, including the Ashenwood. So all the yellow, orange, red. And this one has a little yellow in it. It's more green than yellow, I know, but it has a little bit in it. So that would be the second layer. So let's just take two stacks here real quick so I can show you what I think of doing with that. I did fill in, you know, a lot of the ground. Wonder why this tunnel here. Maybe it must be the lighting updates or something. I didn't have that issue before the last update. So let's say this would be the first one, the Craigwood right here. So I was thinking of making, I'm going to leave this in here in the ground. I'm not going to pick this up again. Who cares about the stone? But, you know, make the border out of this yellow concrete, for example, or maybe something else. But I think this yellow concrete would be the best to me. And then, you know, just fill in the whole petal here with for example, the Craigwood leaves. And you guys get the idea, fill this entire thing. I think one layer should be enough to get a chance to get flowers. I do have to find out. I remember in season one, I made it too thick. And I recall somebody mentioning it that it needs to be at least two. And if that is the case, well, no problem. I got more than enough leaf. Maybe I'll just go ahead and make it too thick. I never had any flowers in season one, I remember that, spawn underneath. So from the bottom of the two layer, there was a two layer gap for me to walk through. I never had any, they always spawned on the top. And maybe you guys have some information about that. That would be awesome if you have experience with a flower farm. If they can spawn on the sides or underneath, does it need to be too thick or whatever? It would be great to hear in the comments if you guys to take the moment. Otherwise, I'm gonna, you know, make a bunch of yellow concrete and fill all this in here with the five petals, one layer thick first. And then I'm gonna wait for the comments, and if somebody says, yeah, it should definitely be two, I have experience with that or something, then I'll try to add a second layer on it. And in here, I'm not sure yet what I'm gonna make. It's possible that I leave it sand. The only thing is, now let's see here, for example, if I want to grow beeswax and cactus. Cactus is no problem. I could have, for example, let's say here, one there, one there, one there, one here, 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 and there. So these would be cactus. They can grow flowers. And then I can have, let's see how we're gonna do this. One here, and you need to remember that they become, so the flower, the actual beeswax that can grow on top can have this, is this gonna be this size here? And on top, this is, yes, the one in the middle, this one right there is, well, this one right there would be the queen bee that I'm gonna plant on the leaf block. And then this is what it grows to. So this would be the first one. So I could have a second one right there. Yeah, something like this. I think, yeah, I think that works out great. So just so it's evenly spread out, and then I can get a third one here and then another one there. So I could have four for queen bees and eight over here for cactus in the middle. And maybe I flip-flop this, put one cactus there and the other queen bees over here, so it's symmetrical, something like that. Anyways, guys, that's the time I got for today. And again, sorry that it took so long for this third episode in this season two to come out, but technical difficulties just didn't allow me. Wonder how long this guy's gonna keep doing that. I love it. And I'll talk to you guys in the next episode. Take care, stay safe, and bye-bye.